guys, it's Kaya, aka Kaya Nichelle, and I'm back again with another video today. This is going to be a little bit different from any of the content that I've uploaded at this point in time because it's going to be my first story time video. Yeah. So, basically, the people that I know, like my friends personally, they've been telling me to do a story time video for a while because apparently my life is just, you know, that entertaining to them. Like my dismay stories. But, I guess they're kind of interesting, for lack of better words. So, if you can't tell by the title, this story time is going to be about the time that I met the side chick or the other girl or one of the, you know, floozies or whatever you want to call it. So, yeah. So, if you want to hear about this story about, you know, such a typical situation in today's society, unfortunately, then continue to watch. So this occurred over a year ago. This was all that I'm gonna say happened in the fall of 2014. So it's 2016 now, so this was over a year ago. Excuse me. So this was my junior year in high school. So basically, I was involved with this guy for a long time, and we had this really on again, off again relationship. So on the offs, there were other people involved. Over time, it became other people involved on both ends, but at this point, it was only other people involved on his end. So it was November, and I went on a trip to Louisiana with my school. Like, we went on a college tour to see, like, LSU, Dillard, Xavier, and some other schools in Baton Rouge and New Orleans. So before I left, like, we were not on good terms. Like, we were not on good terms at all. Like, I think I saw him in the hallway before our buses loaded to go out of state, and like, it was just dead silence, like no communication whatsoever. So we were obviously not in a good space at this point. But like, it's when you're in one of those mentalities, like you're in a mentality, well, even though this is going on, like we're still gonna get back on, which we eventually did. Well, not eventually, like after this whole situation occurred. Don't be like me, girls, like let that go. But so yeah, I went out of town, and my room, our roommates, hotel mates or whatever, two of the girls I was really cool with, like one of them is like a childhood friend of mine, and another one of them, we became close over the year preceding this situation, and then another girl who was in his grade, because he was a grade ahead of me, who was cool with him. So when we were in the hotel room, we're just having like, you know, girl talk and, you know, blase blase whoop de whoop. So I wasn't really paying too much mind to while I was on the trip, but I guess it was either the night before we were supposed to come back home or the morning that we were supposed to come back home. So I don't know, some subliminals and some shade or something was thrown on Twitter. I didn't follow his Twitter, but all of them followed his Twitter. So he said something. I don't even remember what it was along the lines of, but something was said and about something. Something about something, and it got me in my feelings. I was really like emotional at this point in time because like we had a really like peak and trough type of relationship. So I just was feeling some type of way about everything he did. So he said something on Twitter. I had him follow him, but they showed me and it was like, oh, the Kaya, blah blah blah. So needless to say, whatever was said on Twitter, I really don't even remember at this point, because the fact that I allowed that to let me get so riled up is another story. But whatever was said had me in my feelings. So the whole ride home, I was just like in my feelings, like airplane mode, blocking everybody out. And yeah, so the trip ends and I get back to the school. My mom picks me up and we're heading home. But because of the long trip, I was hungry. So I was like, okay, I want some Chick-fil-A. So she's like, okay. So there's a Chick-fil-A in between my house and the school. So we stop at the Chick-fil-A on the way to the house, which is literally like maybe 10 minutes from the school and 3 minutes from my house. So we stop at the Chick-fil-A, and she just gives, I have money left over from the trip or whatever, so I use it to go inside and pay for my food. So I go into the Chick-fil-A, and I'm just standing in line, minding my business. I do the same thing every time, not looking at the board. So when it's my turn, I don't think it was that many people in there, but there was like three people at the register, three registers open or whatever, and they're all teenagers, I do believe. So one of the girls I like kind of recognized because I had like seen her on Twitter or Instagram or something like that, or the guy that I was messing with at the time has showed her to me, or no, she mentioned him on Twitter a couple times. So as a girlfriend, I was like, okay. So yeah, so I see this girl, I'm like, she looks familiar. And then I remember where I've known her from or seen her before, when I see her name tag. So I go up to the counter and I make my order. And if you know about Chick-fil-A, instead of giving you a number, most of the time they ask for your name. So I make my order, and I'm at her register, by the way. I make my order, and when she's like, can I have a name for the order? And I'm like, Kaya. When I tell you guys, her eyes got so wide, you would have thought that she was a deer stuck in headlights when I say my name. Like, she literally did, like, she was like looking down at the screen. I said, Kaya. She said, okay. I'm like, hold up. Like, that was enough. Like, as a female, you know when something's not right. And her reaction alone was enough to tell me that, okay, something ain't right here. So I get my food, and like, I'm on my phone, like, just waiting for my order. The whole time that I'm just standing there waiting for my food, this girl's eyes do not come off me. Like, I'm just like, okay, I already know what the deal is. Like, I think I may have looked her up on Twitter, because I'm like, yep, this her. Yeah, that's that girl from the mentions. That's that girl. Like, who's in my boyfriend's, ex-boyfriend's, on and off again. Okay, this is the thing. The thing about the situation that I have with this guy, like, even if we were not on at the time, like, you knew about me, and vice versa, like, we're common knowledge. Like, if you know about him, you know about me, and vice versa. So she knew my name. Like, you could tell on this girl's face she knew my name. So it's just like, yeah, because he told me not to worry about this girl on Twitter. And I see her, I sound real ratchet, I see her in person, and this is her reaction. Obviously I was not crazy, something was up. So I get my food, I get in the car, and I'm like, mama, this girl, blah blah blah. I just started going off. I'm like, he's messing with this girl, blah blah. And mind you, we are not on at this point, like, at this point in time. So it's just like, I'm upset, like, the Twitter whatever happened earlier plus what happened just then. I was just like, okay, you know what, it's whatever. Like, this boy's messing with this girl, and I'm just so over it. So I come to my house, and I eat my food, and I'm just like getting ready to unpack, get in the shower or whatever. So while I'm in the bathroom, like on the toilet or something, my phone buzzes, and it's him. And I'm just like, okay, we have not talked for almost a week. So obviously this girl has contacted him and be like, yeah, I saw your ex. So the nature of this conversation was something like this, and I don't recall exactly verbatim, but it was something along the lines of this. So I don't even know what the conversation started, but it had nothing to do with that. So my first response when I saw his, I was like, oh, so she texted you. He's like, what are you talking about? I'm like, the girl, like, I'm not gonna say her name, the girl texted you. And he's like, what would she be texting me about? Oh, I went to her. I was like, you know what, it's never, what, let me get my story together. You know what, never mind. He was like, why would you say anything about her? And I was like, because I just went to get some food, and she works there, and I said my name, and she was looking all bewildered. And he was like, oh, swear. I was like, yeah, so what's up? He's like, oh, I just saw her last night. Saw her. What do you mean? Yeah, we went out together last night. Like, I know I'm not crazy, because there's no reason for her to react like that from hearing my name if there was, like, you know, nothing going on. So basically, I went on a trip. We had been off or whatever. I went on a trip. We were like being petty, not speaking to each other. The day that I come back was the day after he went on a date with this girl. And mind you, he's like, oh, it's nothing. Like, he means nothing. Blah, 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 blah. And after that conversation, we ended up getting back together. Yeah, don't do that. Like, Don't do that, y'all. So that's the story about the time I met the other girl. It was super unintentional. Like, it's not like I knew about it and I was like going on to like fight this girl. And I think the reason that she was so like in amazement or like awestruck when she heard my name is because maybe she knew, because she was with him the night previous, like I was up there to start some nonsense. But in actuality, I just wanted an eight count chicken nugget meal. But yeah, God works in mysterious ways, and he puts things in front of you so that you can open your eyes. Even if you don't open your eyes at that moment, which I didn't, it was just one of the many stories, and I promise you there's many stories that are red flags on top of red flags. So I hope that y'all got something from that story, and I don't know what you're gonna get from that story, because I don't even know what I got from that story, except for let the red flags show you up, and if there's other people involved, then maybe you just need to leave that alone completely. So thank you guys for tuning into this first story time. There's gonna be more, because I promise you there's more to hear, because crazy stuff just happens to me. So if you like what you saw and like what you heard, then like, comment, and subscribe on this video. Well, like on this video, comment on this video and other videos, and then subscribe to my channel. Tell your friends about me. So yeah, guys. So I'll see y'all later. Bye.